Circuit de Catalunya, Barcelona. Let's go! Oh, it's a bit twitchy. Just because you can do something doesn't mean you should. I think I've just proven that. This is the all-new Apple TV 4K for 2021, paired with a PlayStation controller playing Real Racing. And I think it's a very good example of how sometimes the app needs to be fully updated to really account for something new, like a controller. I love racing games. I love Real Racing. It's a fun game on the iPad. I never really got into it on the Apple TV. I thought I would with this, but I think it needs a little bit of work. But that's just my crazy feedback about one game. Let's have a look at the brand new Apple TV 4K. Here it is, the Apple TV 4K. The only big difference is the logo has this colorful 4K on it. And that's a very different looking remote. You still get that wonderful drone-like screensavers that you get. I love the one flying over LAX. There's some beautiful ones, but the big difference you'll see when you're using it is this, the Siri remote. We've gone from this really thin touchpad version to this little bit bulky new Siri remote. And it works. It works because it just feels better in the hand. It really does. The thickness, I think, makes a difference. I know they tried to be fancy with this and stick with the original Apple TV remote, but I think they just tried too hard. This has been really well thought out. And I think it's probably based on most of the feedback they've received about the product. Gone is the menu button. Instead, there's now an arrow back, and then there's an Apple TV button, so you can go straight to the Apple TV app, which, by the way, you've got to remember is not Apple TV Plus. The Apple TV app is probably the least rated or the least known feature of Apple TV. It's a combination of all of your streaming services. So you can see here, I've got stuff coming through from 9 Now, as well as stuff that'll be on either Disney or perhaps Apple TV, even down here if we look further, some Amazon Originals on Amazon Prime. It knows what I've got access to and it gives me those things. And it also intelligently places in my Up Next different things based on what we've been watching. That's the smarts of the Apple TV app, leaving aside Apple TV Plus as a standalone subscription service. But the home menu hasn't really changed at all. Still your standard set of icons, as ever you want to arrange them. And on the remote control now, you've got this kind of five-way control. So up, down, left, right, and okay. So pressing is easier just to navigate. You don't have to do that whole intricate swiping, but the whole thing, including the circle, is touch sensitive. So I can swipe, no problem, go up and down and across. And the real beauty of that is when we get into a show. Well, let me show you. And let's use Siri to do that. Play Ted Lasso. Great show. Great show. So let's jump into Ted Lasso on Apple TV Plus.
Get the crap out of there!
On Raw at Richmond.
Now I'm gonna mute that because this remote is paired with my TV and we've got full access. But now that I'm there, I can use this jog wheel on the outside. I can pause the show with the center press. And now look at this, with the jog wheel on the outside, I can simply run around and find my way back, literally almost frame by frame. But it's a really easy way to skip to a section of a show. It works just immensely well. Very nice way, rather than skipping back and forward by 10 seconds or so, you can skip using just that small amount and that intricate adjustments that you want to make. The picture quality is dramatically improved, but only to the video file, the cinema file. I think it's always looked great. But now you have HDMI 2.1, there's support for higher frame rates, higher frame rate HDR, and a whole bunch of extra intricate little things that you can do to ensure that you're getting the absolute most from the content. You know, you want to get Dolby Vision, you've got to have the right support. So all that stuff coming through for the video file, amazing. But you're not going to notice that in a video here on the internet, right? What you can hear from me is connectivity. Wi-Fi 6 on board. That's a great thing in the current world. Mesh network in your Wi-Fi at home. Get yourself Wi-Fi 6 and you don't need the Ethernet anymore. The other thing is it's got support for a thing called Thread, which is a smart home technology, which basically means that all your smart home devices become part of a mesh smart home network. That's also very, very cool. But I have to say, the one thing that I think is most impressive about this device is actually something that needs your iPhone. Now, this is a $11,000 Samsung television. It's their Q950, just beautiful television to look at, a very small bezel, but also great picture quality. But am I getting the right picture quality? Am I getting the right color? And here's what you do. You go into settings, you come down to video and audio, and remember I can swipe this as well. We come all the way down to calibration, color balance. Now at this point, what's gonna happen is we need our iPhone. So we get our iPhone out, we open it up, we unlock with Face ID. And now I get a notice on the screen that says color balance. I press continue, it says preparing. Turn your phone around so the front facing camera points at the television. So now I'm actually gonna place it on the screen because that means that none of the ambient light here in the room will come into the lens. But what it's using is the light sensor on the front of the TV, the light sensor on the front of the phone is seeing these color signals. It's going through all the colors and now these little parts of the different tones of white. Color balance complete. I'm gonna hit go on there. And here's, I don't know that you'll be able to see this, but I can see it. And if I can see it, it's good because my eyes aren't that great for viewing these kind of things. If we go view results, so there's two options here. Original, balanced, original. Now, so this is what this scene would have looked like if I hadn't done that color balance. So it's a very, in my eye, just to describe it to you, because it might not come through on the video, it's a very bright beach, beautiful, deep sea. If I click over, the beach becomes, frankly, more sandy. It looks much more sand-like as opposed to white. So you'll see it's kind of a white, and then I flick across, it's a bit more yellow. White and a bit more yellow. So I think that's noticeable. Here in my eye, I think it's noticeable. I hope it comes through to you on the camera. So we're gonna go with used balance. And now we've got an Apple TV outputting a color scheme that matches my TV. And I tell you where this is gonna be amazing. Cheap TVs. This is an expensive TV. The balance was probably minor. Put this on a TV you bought at Aldi. Put this on a Kogan and you're gonna start to get a really great picture because I think rather than adjusting the TV, the Apple TV does the adjusting for you. That is brilliant. And I think it's gonna enhance what you get from the Apple TV. It's a great device. It always was a great device. I don't think it's there's a reason to run out and get this one if you've got the original or the previous 4K. It's exactly the same size box. It looks almost identical. It's only those feature enhancements in terms of the picture quality. But for a video file, a cinema file, absolutely no brainer, get this one. If you've still got the original thin first generation with the silver remote, get rid of that. It's time to upgrade. This new remote control, very, very nice. Uses lightning to charge and a slightly new button arrangement. But most importantly, we've got a power button to turn on and off, which will also work with your TV. And you've got a slightly new menu arrangement. But broadly, it's the Siri that matters. Hey Siri, I want to watch Top Gear. And I get all the options. So it's a universal search. Let's see how it goes with 9 Now content. Show me Lego Masters. Boom. Lego Ninjago, not a bad show, but we all want Lego Masters with Hamish and Brickman. Who doesn't have a man crush on Brickman, okay? The man gets emotional at the right times. It's an awesome show. If you haven't seen it, the last season was awesome. Some of the best builds ever. So there it is, the all new Apple TV with a brand new Siri remote and a whole bunch of great color and performance and essentially picture quality improvements, as well as that awesome color balance. Full details, full review on the website.